Hi, let's talk about the ligaments and membranes of the larynx. Now, there are both extrinsic and intrinsic membranes and ligaments. Extrinsic membranes and ligaments are elements which will connect the laryngeal skeleton to something external to the larynx, whereas intrinsic are elements that are of the larynx. So let's first look at those extrinsic membranes. So the hyoid cartilage is approximately there, and extending between the hyoid cartilage and the thyroid cartilage, which effectively suspends the larynx, is the thyrohyoid membrane. That thyrohyoid membrane is traversed by some important neurovasculature, which we can see there, and this will include the internal branch of the superior laryngeal nerve, as well as the superior laryngeal artery, which is a branch of the superior thyroid artery. Also, an extrinsic ligament, but we can't see it very well here, is going to be, you can barely see it right there, the Cricotracheal ligament. If the thyrohyoid membrane suspends the larynx, the cricotracheal ligament is going to suspend the trachea from the larynx. And we'll see this in a better view elsewhere. The intrinsic laryngeal membranes are one of two. Superiorly, we have the quadrangular membranes. There is a left and a right quadrangular membrane, and inferiorly we have the conus elasticus. The quadrangular membrane is a membrane for shaping how air travels inward or through the larynx toward the lungs. There are two parts to it. There are aryepiglottic ligaments that rest in the aryepiglottic folds, and then the free edge are the vestibular ligaments. The vestibular ligaments run between the arytenoid cartilages and the thyroid cartilages. And sometimes they're referred to when invested by mucosa as the false vocal folds. They don't tend to vibrate during phonation. You can vibrate them. So if you're a fan of throat singing and you can, you know, do the those are the vestibular ligaments vibrating. And they're separated from the conus elasticus by the laryngeal ventricle, which is this space here. And the conus elasticus is going to be the inferior membrane, or the distal membrane. Oops. So we can see it running between the vocal process of the arytenoid cartilage and the thyroid cartilage, there and there. These vocal ligaments have thyroarytenoid muscle associated and vocalis muscle associated with them. And when that entirety of those structures are invested by mucosa, we refer to it as the vocal cords. These are the structures that vibrate during phonation. As you're listening to my voice, my very own vocal folds are vibrating. There are two other aspects to the conus elasticus. There is the median cricothyroid ligament and then the lateral cricothyroid ligaments, which you are not responsible in lab. The median cricothyroid ligament is probably best viewed from the anterior, and it's this structure here. It's flanked by these cricothyroid muscles. The median cricothyroid ligament is the structure which is incised during a cricothyrotomy. So that's an emergency airway access procedure. And that is performed because there's no neurovasculature that's superficial to that. And there are two very good anatomical cartilaginous landmarks which are palpable in order to perform that procedure. So we've discussed the extrinsic laryngeal membranes and ligaments, as well as the intrinsic laryngeal membranes, the quadrangular membranes, and the conus elasticus, and their features. Thank you very much for your time.